Leadership drills out when a person faces an obstacle. This is a line said by Captain Raghu, one of the serving captains in our Indian Armed Forces. So today, I, Ayush Bhadauria from OTS, is welcoming you to curb out an obstacle so that you can join the Armed Forces. And that obstacle is the examination conducted by UPSC, that is CDS and NDA. And you all must know that there is not more than a month left in your examination. Okay? So I shall be here delineating you about the tips and ways to crack out this examination. So today's video is all about how to tackle the English section of the CDS and NDA examination. Okay, today I shall be telling you how to deal with the English questions, what to study, what is the perfect strategy so that you can curb out this examination and actually render out an obstacle which is lying in the way of your becoming an army officer. Okay, so let's start. So, I have analyzed the question papers of 2021, 2020, 2019, and I have found a peculiar pattern and a regular one also. So, by my instincts, I shall be boasting you to crack out the English section today in this lecture. Let's get started. Officers Training School, English section of NDA and CDS examination. Now, as I have analyzed, I have found that the English section comprises up of 6 parts. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. There are 6 parts in English question paper. Okay? First things first, sentence completion. Sentence completion questions are asked in English question paper for this examination. And as per I have analyzed, I have found that if you are good with tenses, present, continuous, past continuous, future continuous, present tense, past tense, future tense, if you are good with these, you can easily tackle out the questions which are asked in this section, that is English sentence completion. They will ask you to complete the sentences. They will give the options which will be like verb or maybe subject or maybe object. Okay, so if you are well aware about tenses, then you can easily and very smoothly tackle out this part, sentence completion part. Okay, now second one. Second one is passage reading. If you are a thorough reader of a newspaper on a very regular basis, and not on sporadic basis. If you are regular at reading the newspaper, you will definitely very easily tackle out this section, that is passage reading. If you have not started yet, then start it from today. Okay? If you will start reading the articles or in the newspapers, you will actually emanate a habit, a very good habit of reading the paragraph in a very profound manner. And that will definitely bolster you in your examination, where the passages will come and you will have to answer the questions related to those passages. And there are many questions asked about the passages, and passages also come in different, you know, different dimensions. The passage can be of environment, it can be for economy, it can be for polity or in any other field. But if you are a very thorough reader, you can definitely very easily carve out the questions which are asked to them. And there is not only a single passage asked in this paper, there are multiple passages. That is, you will definitely score very good marks if you have this thorough reading habit of newspapers. If you don't have that habit, please develop it now. It will definitely bolster you in your all examinations, and especially in this CDS and NDA. Since there is only 1 month left, you don't have enough time, but still you can start it from today. It's never too late, as it said. Okay? Now, that after this sentence completion and the passage reading, there is another dimension to the English paper, that is antonym and synonyms. Now, I will give you a very delightful insight about antonyms and synonyms. See, everything is interconnected. If you will be a thorough reader of a newspaper, you will definitely find out new words regularly in the newspaper. As soon as you find out any new word, as soon as you tackle any new word in the newspaper, just look at its meaning and its synonyms. Write down somewhere, maybe in a copy or maybe in your phone or wherever you like to write the stuff. Write it down, revise it on a regular basis, and within 2 to 3 months, you will essentially develop a habit of doing this. And within no time, you will see the change in yourself, that you are now commanding a varied kind of different, varied kind of words of English language. Okay? So, if you have not done this thing yet, as I have said to you earlier, start reading the newspaper. It will bolster you in your passage reading, in your antonyms and synonyms section. And for now, find out a booklet which consists of antonyms and synonyms. Just by heart them, by heart all the words which are given in it, and they will help you in your question paper. But develop this habit also. Reading the newspaper is the only habit which can make you a thorough reader and can also help you out in this examination, especially in these parts, passage reading and antonyms and synonyms. Now comes the fourth part. Phrases or idioms of phrases. See, we have started a new series, that is Know Your English, from the newspaper The Hindu. I regularly do that, those videos of Know Your English. In those videos, I on a regular basis tell you about new words, their meanings, and also new phrases. By seeing those lectures also, you can definitely carve out the sections of idioms and phrases and antonyms synonyms in your question paper. They are very short videos of maybe 10 to 12 minutes. It will not consume much of your time, and you will definitely inherit some knowledge of new words, of new phrases in you. And these idioms and phrases, this also you can bolster out by reading newspaper on a regular basis. So I have just compiled it all, and I bring it to you on a regular basis in the section Know Your English. Okay, just check out those videos and you will definitely benefit yourself for the section of idioms and phrases and antonyms and synonyms, which are necessary for clearing out this examination, especially the English section. Now, next thing is, active and passive voice. This is also sporadically asked in the question papers. I have seen the questions relating to active and passive. See, sentence completion, active, passive, and one more thing is spotting the error. These all can be tackled if you have a comprehensive and synoptical knowledge of tenses, which is the base for English language. Okay? So let me recommend you a book. Any English book from the state government syllabus of English of class 10, it will definitely help you to gain the valuable knowledge of English language, and they will teach you the book. If you will read the book will definitely teach you about tenses, and if you once get to know the tenses well, you will very easily tackle the sentence completion part, the spotting the error parts, and the active and passive voice. Although active and passive voice is a separate subject in those books, in every state board books of class 10, there are active, passive, direct, indirect, and the tenses. These three things you will have to learn from the book of state board of class 10. From in UP board, I know about UP board. There is a book called Murari English, M-U-R-A-R-I, Murari English. This book subsumes tenses, sentence formation, direct, indirect, and active passive section. There is nothing which comes into the paper and goes beyond that syllabus. ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है जो इस क्वेश्चन पेपर में आता हो और उसके सिलेबस के बाहर चला जाए. It actually subsumes the periphery of all the English questions which are asked in the CDS and NDA examinations. Okay? So, last thing, last topic which I must remind you. Direct, indirect, and spotting the errors. I have told you earlier, direct, indirect, active, passive, sentence completion. These three things you can very easily tackle out if you will read the newspaper. Excuse me, guys. I'm so sorry. Yeah. So as I was saying, active passive, direct indirect, sentence completion, These three things you can very easily tackle out if you will be comprehending the state level books of English of class 10. For UP board, I have actually recommended a book also, that is Muradi English. Okay, now this section, spotting the errors. It is a section, these are the questions which are very regularly asked in examination. In each and every examination, spotting the errors is must for the examiner to ask to the aspirants and the candidates. Okay, now if you will be having a knowledge of proper sentence formation, then you will have no hurdle, no impediment to tackle out the questions related to spotting the errors. अगर आपको सेंटेंस कंप्लीट करना आता होगा, सेंटेंस बनाना आता होगा, टेंस की पूरी जानकारी होगी, तो आप बहुत ही आसानी से स्पॉटिंग द एरर्स कर पाओगे. फॉर एग्जांपल, आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन माय वीडियो ऑफ नो योर इंग्लिश हाउ टू यूज द वर्ड READ एज अ नाउन एंड एज अ वर्ब. आई हैव गिवन एन एग्जांपल इन दैट वीडियो दैट सम मे फाइंड दिस सेंटेंस रॉन्ग, बट इट इज नॉट अ रॉन्ग सेंटेंस. द वर्ड रीड यूज्ड देयर वाज एज अ नाउन. ओके, so these are the kind of questions which are asked in the question paper, and if you will watch those videos of Know Your English which is on this channel only, and also will comprehend the books of class 10 of English, you can definitely tackle out the English question paper of CDS and NDE examinations. So that's it for today guys. I hope you have learned something. Thank you.